The medical establishment has called my meteoromatic therapy pseudoscientific. I have been referred to as a fraud, a snake oil salesman, and a charlatan.
These
doctors are laughing at me. But do you know who else they laughed at? Galileo. Guess what? Science was wrong before. I predict that meteoromatic therapy will usher in a new era in the war against cancer. If only these doctors could see what is happening right now in my clinic in Panama City, they wouldn't laugh. Oh, they wouldn't laugh, let me tell you.
This is called the Galileo Gambit, and it's a sign that you've run out of convincing arguments. The Galileo Gambit is a type of bad argument called an association fallacy. Just because you have one thing in common with someone doesn't mean you're exactly like that person. Galileo Galilei, as you may remember, was a scientist during the Renaissance who championed the model that the Earth orbited the Sun. This was, of course, heresy in the face of the Catholic Church, who maintained that the Sun must be orbiting the Earth because human beings are so special. Galileo was tried and put under house arrest. Of course, the world has since come around to the reality that the Earth does in fact orbit around the Sun. Galileo was a nonconformist. He ruffled a lot of feathers, and turns out, he was right. Good for him. Not everyone who holds a seemingly crazy idea turns out to be right. In the early 19th century, Dr. Gall came to believe that bumps on people's brains represented mental faculties, and by touching a person's skull, one could determine if they were musically inclined, or a murderer. Phrenology, as it came to be called, was just wrong. There have been lots of bad ideas throughout the ages. To say that you'll turn out to be right because Galileo was right is a bad argument. It kills the conversation. The scientists and politicians who use this argument need to stop comparing themselves to Galileo and start bringing evidence to support their position. Galileo was right, not because he championed a cutting-edge idea, but because he had solid evidence behind his claim. If every person who gets laughed at for their unconventional idea turned out to be right, we'd have solved every problem on Earth, and we haven't.